Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. Welcome to another video of Android Dependency Injection Course. And from this video, we will start implementing the things that we learned in the last video. So in the last video, we discussed what actually is dependency injection and how we can use this technique in our Kotlin codes. And from this video, we will work in an actual Android project. And here I have my project opened. And this is the code from one of the previous tutorial, that is Android login and sign up tutorial with MVVM architectural pattern. So you can watch this course from here. I will give the link here. And if you want the source code of this project, you can get it from the link that is given in the description of this video. So here you can see the project is opened and this is the login fragment. And if I run the app, it is working absolutely fine. So you can see I logged out and I can even log in like this. So I can log in inside the application and it is working absolutely fine. So I hope you know the basic application architecture that is recommended for Android. And in this architecture, first we create a repository that communicates with our backend API or local database. And then we create ViewModel and we observe the data from ViewModel inside our fragment or activity. So right now I am inside login fragment, and to create the ViewModel, I need the repository, I need the local preferences, I need the API, and I also need the remote data source. So all these things are dependencies for my login fragment. And right now I am not using any dependency injection in this project. So what is the drawback of coding like this? So for example, I also need to create sign up fragment. Right now it is login fragment. I also need to create sign up fragment, and in sign up fragment as well, I need all these things. So what I need to do is I need to copy and write the same code there and sign up fragment as well. And that is not a good idea because I am duplicating the code. So later if I want to change something, I need to change every place. So this is not a good approach. And as we discussed in the last video, my login fragment is constructing all else dependencies. That should not happen because all the dependencies should be given from outside the class, and the class should not construct its own dependencies. So right now we will try to perform or use the dependency injection technique in this project, but we will not use any third party library, that is Dagger or Hilt. But first we will try to do the dependency injection manually in this project. And then after doing it manually, we will move to the libraries like Hilt or Dagger, so that we will understand why exactly a library is needed. So what first I will do is I will create a new package inside my main package, and I will name it DI, that means dependency injection. Inside this package, I will create a class and I will name it app container. Now inside this class, I will construct all the dependencies. So what I will do is I will copy everything from here and I will paste everything here. Now we need context to construct API and preferences. So what I'll do is I will pass context to app container. So we have context here like this, and instead of require context, I will pass the context here like this. Now I will make all these things private because I don't think I will need it outside the class. So let's make everything private for now. Now one more thing is remaining, that is called ViewModel. Now ViewModel also we need in many places. For example, I need this auth ViewModel inside my signup fragment as well. And it is also a good idea to use a factory pattern for these kind of situations. So for ViewModel, I will create a factory. So I will go to new and I will select Kotlin file class. I need to do it again. And I will name it factory, and I will create an interface so that I can use the same interface to create any type of view model. So I will write the type as T because I want to create it as a generic type. And now I will create a function that is fun create, and it will create the view model. and it will return T. That will be our view model. Now I will create one more class and I will name it auth view model factory. Now inside this class I will inherit factory, and from this class I need to build auth view model. So I will define it here like this, auth view model, and we will implement the members. We have create function. Now here we will return auth view model like this. Now to create auth view model, we need auth repository, and this repository we will pass to the constructor of auth view model factory. So here I will write private val auth repository and repository, and here we can pass auth repository. So we have the factory that will construct our auth view model. Now I want to manage the dependencies according to my application's flow. And right now, the first flow that I have in my application, it is this login or authentication flow. So I have this auth activity. Inside this activity, I have two fragments that will require the authentication kind of dependencies. So I will construct the dependencies for auth activity, and we will remove all the dependencies from the memory when the auth activity is destroyed. So for this flow, I will create one more container, and I will name this container as auth container because it is for authentication flow. Now inside this auth container, I will define val auth view model factory equals to auth view model factory. And for auth view model factory, we require the auth repository. So we will pass the auth repository to the constructor of this class auth container. So here I will define auth repository, and now we can pass this auth repository here like this. So we have our auth container. Now we will go to our app container class, and here inside this class, first we will define val auth container because this will contain all the dependencies that are required for authentication flow. So here I will define auth container of type auth container, and I will make it nullable, and the initial value is null because I want this dependencies only for the authentication flow. So when the authentication flow is started, I will initialize this auth container, and when the authentication flow is finished, I will assign null again to this auth container. So let's do it. What I will do is I will go to auth activity, and here I will define latinetvar app container. So we have the app container here. Now to initialize the app container, we can use the application class that we already have here. So we will go to class myApplication, and inside this class, we will override the function onCreate like this. And here I will create latinetvar app container like this. And inside the onCreate function, I will write app container equals to app container. And this class requires a context, so we can pass this because we are inside application class. So when our application is launched, the app container is initialized. Now come back to app container, and we have this auth container here inside our app container class. And we need to initialize this auth container inside our auth activity. Now let's do it. So before setting the content view, I will initialize the app container. Not app container, actually the auth container that we have inside the app container. So here I will write app container dot auth container equals to auth container like this. Now this container requires auth repository, and we can get the auth repository from our app container. So here we can write app container dot. We need to make the repository public. So this is the auth repository. So I will remove private from the auth repository, and now we can access it here. So we have auth repository like this. We need to change this val to var because we want to make it mutable so that we can reassign the value for this auth container. Now let's go back to auth activity. Now here we have our app container and we have initialized the auth container inside our app container. Now what we can do is we can override the function on destroy, and inside this function what I can do is I can write app container dot auth container equals to null. So when this flow is finished, we will remove the container from the memory by assigning null. So that's it. Now our container is ready and now we can inject the dependencies using the container. So let's do it. Come to login fragment. And here I will delete everything. Now this time to initialize ViewModel, we will use the app container that we created. So here what I'll do is I will write require activity and I will cast it to auth activity like this. And then I will write dot app container. We will get the app container. And from the app container, we will get auth container. And from the auth container, we will get the ViewModel factory. So we will get auth ViewModel factory from here like this. And from this factory, we will create the ViewModel like this. Now this auth container is nullable, so we need to add the question mark here like this. And now we have our view model ready. Now I will change the view model to nullable and the initial value is null like this. And here we need to add question marks. So I have added null safety everywhere and that's it. Now we removed all the code duplication and we are injecting the view model with the help of our app container. So this is the manual approach of doing dependency injection. Now let's try running the application to see if it is working or not. Oops, the application is crashing and I think I missed something here. So let's check the auth activity. And yeah, I forget to initialize the app container here. So what I will do is I will write app container equals to application as my application, that is my application class, and then app container. Now that's it. It should work now. Let's try again. So you can see here that the application is working absolutely fine. Let's try login in. So we are logged in and it is working absolutely fine. So what we did here is called manual dependency injection. Now there are some problems with this approach. The problem with this approach is we need to manage the app container ourselves. As we are managing the app container, we need to create all dependencies manually by hand. And that is why we still have a lot of boilerplate code in the project. As you can see, we are maintaining the dependency graph manually for application's flow. For example, in the current project, we created auth container for auth flow. And we also removed auth container from memory when the auth flow is finished. It is okay now, but as the application grows, it is very difficult to optimize the dependencies. And it is very much possible that we will forget releasing the dependency from memory. So optimization here is very hard and error prone with this approach. And finally, the more you do things manually, the more the chances are of making error. So that's being said, in the next video, we will start using an automation framework for dependency injection. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. In case you have any question, problem or confusion, please leave it in the comment section below. And if you like this video, then please hit on that like button. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already a subscriber. And please share this video with all your friends learning Android application development. So that is all for this video, friends. Thanks for watching. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.